Hey everyone, I'm Sumik Agarkar and welcome to Agarkar Media Academy. This is the 13th tutorial in Blender tutorial series for beginners. In the last tutorial, we saw how to use PBR materials to give realistic looking textures or materials to our objects in 3D. So before we move on to this tutorial, I just want to say if you haven't yet subscribed to this YouTube channel, please do subscribe. It's Agarkar Media Academy. And if you go into the playlist section, you will here find the playlist for Blender 3D animation tutorials where I'm putting out almost daily tutorials for Blender. So in the last tutorial, we were here. We basically downloaded this texture from PBR texture from CC0 textures. And there we got these five maps: AO, color, displacement, normal, and roughness. So of the five, we used color map, normal map, and roughness map to give this almost realistic looking texture or material to the default cube. Now, in the last tutorial, before we ended the tutorial, we talked about how what should be done to scale up or scale down the texture right here on this 3D object. So it can be possible that you don't want the bricks to be of so big size, you want the bricks to be smaller sizes. Then what should be done? So this is exactly what we are going to understand in this tutorial, and we are just going to use the nodes here in the node editor to achieve the effect that we want. So before we understand, before we hop into how to do that, first let's understand how texturing works in Blender or in any other animation, 3D animation or 3D modeling softwares. So right here in the layout panel, we basically have three axes. If I just go to the rendered mode, we basically have three axes to work on: X, Y, and Z. We have already seen how to work with moving, scaling, and rotating inside of X, Y, and Z axis, right? So 3D space is defined by these three axes: X, Y, and Z. Now, the textures are not defined in X, Y, Z axis. They are not three dimensionals. Here you can see the textures are not three dimensionals. They are two dimensionals. So we need a way to convert the three dimensional space or three dimensional objects to be mapped to a two dimensional texture. So for that, what we use is we use the UV coordinate system. So textures work on UV coordinate systems and not on XYZ coordinate system. So UV coordinate system is basically what we define the vertices of the 3D three dimensional space and then map them onto a two dimensional coordinate system called UV coordinate system. Now here you can see UV editing panel right here. We'll be looking at how to actually convert the three dimensional space to two dimensional coordinate system, that is a UV coordinate system, in the next tutorial. But just to give you an idea, in UV editing we'll be doing that. Right now in this tutorial we are not going to do that, we are going to do that in the next tutorial. Right now we are just going to understand how to scale up or scale down the texture coordinates and how to basically map the coordinate systems to this object that we already have. So now that I have already told you how the texturing and texture coordinate system works, first to scale up and scale down here we need a coordinate system. We need the texture coordinate system as an input, as an output from somewhere which we can use as input to other nodes. Right now what we have done is we have just used the textures that we have got from the PBR material and directly put on to the principal BSDF all these functionalities, right? So but we have no way to, you know, control the texture coordinate system. So to control the texture coordinate system, we first need a texture coordinate node. Also one thing, we have already got this screencast keys option on again. For the last few tutorials, it wasn't working correctly and I just figured it out how to do it correctly and now it's working. So anyways, Shift A to add a node, and what we are going to do is we are just going to search for a new node. We are not going to find the nodes in all these things. We can just search the node right here, and because we know what we want to search, we don't need to go for, you know, opening up every other panel and just see and just find the node that we want. We want a texture coordinate node. So search texture coordinate and texture coordinate node. That's it. Good. We have the texture coordinate node. Now, what we wanted, there are many options and we are not going to look at all the options just right now, maybe in some other tutorials. Right now we just want to work with the UV coordinate systems, right? So I'm just putting in UV coordinates to all these three. Now understand that when we are using that, when we are, you know, putting up one coordinate texture, one coordinate system to the input of vector to any texture, then we need to do that for all the other textures that we are using. Otherwise, what are the problems will be happening, I'll be showing you right now. Now, as soon as I joined this UV coordinate to all the vectors of all the textures right here, no difference happened. Why? Because already we were using the UV coordinate system, and we just did it by default. It was using the UV coordinate system, and then again we are saying that use the UV coordinate systems, and that's why there is no difference that's happening. Now, to make a difference, we basically need to map it and change the scale, right? We need to map and change the scale. So for mapping, we use a mapping node. So shift A for add and mapping node. And I'm using this mapping node right here, right? Now, understand that I am using the mapping node just to the color coordinate system, not to any other textures. Right now, I'm just using it to the this vector of the input to the mapping node is the UV coordinate, and the output is to the color texture, right? Now here we have three different options: location, rotation and scale. Let's start with scale. Let's increase the scale on any one axis. Let's say we just increase the scale of x to 2. If we are increasing the scale of x to 2, we also need to increase the scale. Right just here you can see that it has been shrinked in just one direction, but it has not shrinked in the other direction, right? So because that is what we want to happen, we need to scale it up exactly same by same factor on all three axes, right? All three directions. So now here we have scaled up the color coordinate by 2, 2 and 2. So basically we are now using twice the space on the same texture, on the same object. Now here you can, I'm just dropping it down. Now here you can see the problem, why I said that we need to use this vector right here, right? See, the color texture has been scaled by 2, right? It is scaled twice. You can see the color texture twice, but the roughness map and the normal map, because we are still using the same original coordinate system, original UV coordinates maps, it has not been scaled. So every time you have to be very careful here, that when you are mapping one texture, then you have to also map the same texture, same other texture by the same mapping node. So when we do the mapping input to all the three textures, now it's working correctly, right? See, it's now working exactly same the way we wanted, right? So this is the use of texture coordinate and mapping node. Now of course this is a disadvantage, that all the time you have to, you know, search for the texture coordinate node and search for the mapping node and then hook it up to the other textures. There is a faster way to do that. Let's just delete it. Let's go to the edit panel, preferences, and in preferences let's go to add-on, and in add-on we have an add-on called node wrangler. This one, node wrangler, by default it is off, but it is installed. By default it is off. We have to just make it on, just enable it, and here we can just save the preferences so that it always works. Basically the use of node wrangler add-on is that it provides shortcuts for the node editing panel. So this is our node editor panel, right? We are inside of the node editor, and here it provides some shortcuts. So if I just select this texture, color texture, and I just click Control T. So as soon as I did the Control T, you can see that the texture coordinate node and the mapping node has been already joined to it. This is really, really cool. Let's just see if it works with all the three of them. I just selected all three of them and Control T, and now here you can see a new texture coordinate and a map has been added to all three of them. We just don't want that, we are just going to use for one. select one of them. Control T and the texture coordinate and the mapping node has been added. Now we just need to do is just move them aside and hook them up to the other coordinate nodes or other textures also. And just let's increase the scale to 2, 2, and 2. And that's it. It's now working. So you have every control over how to use that. You can just rotate. Here you can see if I rotate what happens. Right? If I rotate on Y. Now this is about the rotation of textures. So it's not going to work exactly properly. Here this is the best way to slide the texture. Just change the location. If you change the location, it will just work. X, Y, and Z. So this Z is not going to have any difference here because we are just this object is just using the XY coordinate system and not the Z coordinate system. I'll be telling you about that and how and why it's happening in the next tutorial when we do the UV editing. So this is it. Now you have exact control over how much scale of the texture do you want on the object. So this is it for this tutorial. If you learned something new, please give it a thumbs up. If you haven't yet subscribed to this YouTube channel, please do subscribe. If you have any queries or any suggestions, please do comment in the comment section below. Please share this video with your friends and family so that they can also learn to use Blender animation software and create really awesome 3D animations and VFX by themselves. See you in the next tutorial. Till then, keep smiling and keep learning.